Hello, I'm Fast Lawyer. Today we're going to do a review for Car Mechanic Simulator VR, a game released on the Steam Store June 8th, 2021 by developer Gameformatic SA and publisher Playway SA. It normally retails for $20. It's currently on a release sale, 10% off. I actually bought it at a cheaper discount because I own some other titles by Playway, so I got $4 off, so I only paid $14. It's available for the Valve Index, the HTC Vive, the Oculus Rift, and Windows Mixed Reality. I tested this game out on the Oculus Quest 2 using the Oculus Link cable. Car Mechanic Simulator VR is a VR port of the game Car Mechanic Simulator 2018. Now, this game is currently rated mostly negative on Steam, and there's good reason for that. However, I'm going to give this game a neutral recommendation, a 5 out of 10. I think there are good things about this title, as well as some bad things. The best way I can describe the bad is that this is clearly a VR port of a pancake game, and you can tell when playing this game that this game just wasn't built from the ground up for VR, and as such is just missing a lot of the quality of life interactions and mechanics that we're used to in VR. This game has a lot of point and click interactions that are just not very immersive, but it's not all bad, and I think some people might really enjoy this game as long as you're willing to accept this game for what it is, which is it's a VR port and it's not a really well-made port of a non-VR game. However, this game does have a lot there to like. If you're willing to get your hands dirty, deal with a lot of frustration, you will end up liking the net effect for your struggles. For your struggles, you will get a game that's worth getting into. Keep in mind, this is not pure simulator, so if you're expecting something like Ranch, which is more on the simulation side, you'll be sorely disappointed by this title. However, it's not pure arcade either. I'm not a big car guy myself, but I know a little bit, and I think this game is perfect for someone like me, whereas Wrench might be a little too much for someone like me who doesn't have the in-depth knowledge about car parts and mechanical issues. And this game does have a fun gameplay loop where you just get more and more vehicles with an increasing amount of difficulty in fixing them, but you also get level ups and you add more to your car garage, so it ends up being a fun gameplay loop, but there are lots of issues getting to that point, and a lot of people may not want to put up with all the issues in this title. Car Mechanic Simulator VR is running on the Unity engine on my RTX 3080. I was getting a consistent 90 frames per second for the most part on high graphical settings. There are several settings available in this game, lots of graphical settings, lots of sound settings. A lot of people were complaining on the Steam reviews that you couldn't lower the volume for the music. That's just not true. You can lower the volume in the settings in the main menu area, and you can also lower the music by turning off the radio that is in the garage. You do have full locomotion and smooth turning available, as well as teleportation options, so there are lots of options here. The problem is that a lot of the interactions are point and click, which is odd because there are some interactions that are pretty neat. You do have an electric screwdriver, and you can use that to unscrew and screw back several of the parts, and when you do that, that is pretty neat. However, you can also just click on it and you have a little pointer running from your finger, and you can just automatically screw them on and off, which is a lot faster and a lot easier to do than using the screwdriver. I think this is an odd choice by the developers, and there's just a lack of a tool belt, which you would need to be able to use the screwdriver comfortably. And there's several interactions in this game which you think you can do manually, but you end up finding out that you can't. You just have to go to this wheel menu that's a lot of the things, and you select the action from this wheel menu, which is very immersive braking. One of your first jobs is to change the oil, and so you lift up the car, and even that's a clunky interaction. You try to point at the button to power on this vehicle lifter, and it ends up being a very cumbersome process that doesn't always work. And then you try to press the button for it to go up, and you have to do several tries. And then once you do all that, then you have this machine which lets you drain the old oil from the vehicle, and you think you can do this manually, but you cannot. I tried to do it manually. I tried to figure out how to do it, but it just wouldn't work. I ended up having to use the wheel menu and just have the thing happen automatically with hardly any real interaction from me other than just a point and click and choose from the wheel operation, and that's just not fun. And that's a big missed opportunity by this developer. You want to make interactions that really bring you into this world, that immerse you in this world. A lot of the fun of playing this type of game is getting to simulate the real world actions in VR. Maybe they're not as difficult, but just some of the interactions make you believe that you're really there and that you're really doing these things. But with the way it's done in this game, with the point and click and use the wheel function, it's very immersive breaking and it ends up not being fun. Something that should be fun, the funnest part of the game. That's what we want in VR. That's the magic of VR, and it's just missing in this game, and it's just a real mess by this developer. Like I said, there are some fun parts to this game. Once you get going, you can look past that the interactions are not as immersive as they should be. However, even that is a little frustrating just because a lot of the operations are not very intuitive. I did the tutorial and I still couldn't figure out how to do a lot of the very basic stuff here, and it was just through trial and error and a lot of frustration that I think I finally figured this game out. But yeah, it took a while. I did experience some bugs during my gameplay. I did have to restart the game at least one time. However, there was nothing game breaking where I was just locked from the game. And definitely the most fun part for me was definitely fixing your own car and then being able to take it out for a spin. That was really cool. But again, this game is a bit buggy. The interactions are not very good. Even driving the vehicle isn't very immersive, but it works. And I guess that's just the theme from this game. If you're willing to put up with some frustration, there is quite a bit to enjoy here. The gameplay loop is fun, but a lot of people may not be willing to put up with the frustration that this game creates. So as you know, I already said I'm gonna give this game a neutral recommendation, a 5 out of 10. Really, I only recommend it for people who really like Car Simulator 2018. If you played that game, you know what you're getting. And just keep in mind, this is a VR port and not a very well made VR port. Hopefully it gets more support in the future, get some updates to make the game more immersive, and that would really make this game something special to play in VR. Right now it isn't. Anyways, I'm Fast Lawyer. If you like my review, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. And as always, have a wonderful day and enjoy the rest of the video.